na agad-agad. Dahil dyan, makagaling na ninyong pamasko from me dahil alam niyo naman, spoiled sa akin ang mga kagaya mo, gaya ko, at mga kagaya nating lahat sabay-sabay na merong
It's Gold Lab!
Kaya kahit ilang days to go pa before Christmas, you don't have to wait for a week. Lalo pat I'm sure na sa good vibes na pinimigay ko tonight, sure na tayong sasapat ito hanggang next year. Next year, it will be election season once again. Kaya naman, mainit na naman sa mata ng publiko ang mga politiko. Kanya-kanya ba pogi na naman? Kaya our topic for tonight ay ang mga anak ng politiko na hindi na kailangan pang pumorma dahil sa tagline ng good looks. Inom na ng tubig for tonight. We'll list down 5 hot sons of famous politicians. Ito na. First on our list, medyo kontrobersyal at nag-trending pa dahil medyo laddish daw ang lifestyle niya. Well, kayo nang humusga about that. But one thing's for sure is that Julian Estrada inherited his Lolo Erap and Danny Jingboy's movie star looks. He also entered showbiz at nakagawa na rin ng movie, so I'm sure marami pang aabangan from Julian.
Sir Tim, ex daw niya si Julia Barreto.
Oh, eh ano ngayon sa'yo?
Ex niya si Julian, pero ako na ngayon, ang present niya.
Nako, walang future yan. Kayo na lang. Next, still from the Estradas at naging controversial din ang tito ni Julian na si Uno Emilio or Jake Ejercito. Jake is former President Erap's son with former actress Laarni Enriquez at minsan na rin naging talk of the town itong si Jake dahil kumakalat ng Dumanoy pictures niya making out with another girl habang girlfriend niya si Andy Agumar.
Oo na, aminin ko, Sir Tim, ako yung nasa picture.
Ikaw yung kahalikan ni Jake?
Hindi po, ako yung kahalikan ng girl. Joke lang.
From the Estradas, pumunta naman tayo sa pamilyang best friend nila, ang mga Poe. Senator Grace Poe may be a foundling, but her genes are surely beautiful ones. What am I talking about? Isa pa kasing crush ng bayan ngayon ang anak niyang si Brian Poe Lamenzares, who just quit his job as a news reporter to help his mom think over her plans for 2016. Napaka-supportive at thoughtful mo naman, Brian.
Bukod pa dyan, ang gwapo.
Isa pang may pinagmanahan from his showbiz roots, ang susunod sa ating listahan si Ryan Christian Recto, na anak ni Governor Vilma Santos at ni Senator Ralph Recto. Ang bilis naman talaga ng panahon dahil kung dati ay baby brother ni Lucky ang peg ni Christian, ngayon he's a grown man na rin at 18. Although he says he's more interested in politics than in showbiz, I'm sure kahit a few projects lang ay talaga namang kakikiligan at titilian din itong first son ng Batangas. So, sure ka na ba na ayaw mo mag-showbiz?
I love you, Christian. I love you, Lucky. I love you, Ralph. Ikaw na rin, Governor V.
Lastly, let's end the night with a triple threat. Ang three sons si Senator Bongbong Marcos and his wife Lisa. Naging scene stealers at head turners nga ang tatlong Marcos heirs na sina Sandro, Simon at Vincent. Nag-trending pa nga sa Twitter ang Marcos brothers ito dahil marami ang natuwa at nagwapuan sa mga magkakapatid. Sabi nga ng iba, mukhang nasa dugo talaga ni Madam Imelda ang kanyang love for beauty, kaya pati mga apo niya talaga namang beautiful faces din.
Kung ako ang yaya ng mga batang yan, malabang alagang-alaga ko mga yan. Pakakainin ko sila ng Nutriban.
Sinong political scion ang hot din para sa inyo? Sige nga, patingin, tweet me the photos or tag me on Instagram at @officialtimyap. Tapos magpa-online poll tayo. Joke lang. Yap, next, ito, hindi biro-biro ang guest natin for tonight because she's one tough cookie. Maraming mga pagsubok ang kanyang pinagdaanan. She's proud to say na na-survive itong lahat. Find out who she is when the Tim Yap Show returns. Ikaw, lunchtime ka na ba? Welcome back to the Tumiak Show. Our next guest is a dear friend of mine, fresh from London, where she finished her schooling 3 years after. She's in a bed of controversy and a lot of things that are new about her. Ladies and gentlemen, Jerica Ejercito. Hello.
Hello.
I forgot, daughter of Manila, Jerica Ejercito.
Hi, darling.
Hello. How are you?
I miss you
so much also. Uh-huh. So many things have happened. Society, It Girl, and everything else.
So,
Jerica, aside from, well, you just gave birth, mm-hmm. right? You have a beautiful baby boy.
That's right.
Isaiah, what was the first thing that you thought of when you saw baby Isaiah?
It was very humbling. Like, wow, it's not about me after all. The world does not revolve around me.
What? It doesn't?
After having him, you know, everything just changed. He's a game changer. I mean, you've met me while I was still, you know, in the party scene and all of that. But having Isaiah really has kept me grounded.
Wow. Okay. So that grounding, what did you realize when you were being grounded by your son?
A lot of things. That life is more about being selfless, you know, instead of thinking about, okay, what will make me feel good or what do I want for myself? It's more of what can I give my son? Mm-hmm. You know, like how can I be the mother that he deserves?
Wow, so swerte naman ng baby mo.
Eh, swerte din kasi ako.
Swerte din, oo. Swerte kayong dalawa sa isa't isa.
Oo.
Wow.
Yeah.
But, you know, when you were single and when you were not yet a mother, mm-hmm. you know, you were very focused on projects for Manila.
Definitely.
You were doing this foundation of yours.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
so, I'm still, well, now that Isaiah is about to turn one, I'd mm-hmm. like to once again turn my focus back on that passion of mine, which is Mental Health Foundation.
Yes, yes.
Outreach. Right now, we're in the process of doing a social experiment mm-hmm. on abused girls. It's very deep. It's very heavy. Yeah. But it's something that...
It needs to be done.
Yeah. That I want to shed light on these kinds of, you know, issues.
You know, people are uncomfortable talking about these things, but, you know, it needs to be talked about.
Yeah.
Diba, napakarami nagpapakamatay.
Exactly.
You know, people do not want to admit that depression exists. Kasi it's such a very happy and positive society that we live
That's
in.
Right. Which is a good thing.
Yes.
It's a good thing. But, you know, we cannot turn our backs on...
We cannot deny
that
depression exists.
Yeah, you're right. That's the right word, definitely. So I want to shed light on certain issues that, you know, people might tend to overlook.
Yes.
You know.
Or not, or deny, not want to see.
Yeah.
Because
it's not a bad thing until you try to understand.
Yes. But see, you know it firsthand because you have friends, or have you experienced it on your own?
Of course I have.
Yes.
I'm not going to deny that. Okay. I have experienced depression. And
how did you detect your depression?
It was coming home kasi.
Oo.
Diba? I was gone for 9 years.
You were used to the, you know, the freedom of London.
Exactly. You know, and I think I labeled it as a reverse culture shock.
Yes.
You know, I left when I was 17. I came back, I was 26. You know, so it's a big change. And I came back and I lived with my parents again.
Yes.
So, you know, parang, oh my God, from freedom to rules and, you know, curfews and this, that, and
the
third.
From living in Europe, then curfew.
Yeah, you know, and living in a place where no one really cared what I did.
Yes,
you know, here, I mean, I have to watch what I say, what I post.
When you post something on Facebook, people react.
Yeah, you know, I have to, you know, censor myself.
I know matagal na yon, di ba? That the post that you made a comment about Chris Aquino. You know, so from one daughter of a president to another, was it taken out of proportion? It was magnified. What happened there?
I think, you know, I have to admit.
Because you never spoke about the matter.
No, because if I did, it would create another monster.
Mm.
You know, I think I had to, you know, rethink what I said.
Uh-oh.
You know, it wasn't an attack against Miss Chris Aquino.
Oh.
You know, I admire her. she's done a lot of good things for other people. It was a mere observation. It wasn't an opinion.
Yeah.
And
the post was Chris Aquino is a brat.
it was. I don't want to say it anymore. But you know, I wish I used another term for it. Yes. It was just an observation that I had made, and I wish I had just kept it to myself. I didn't think people would really care what I had to say.
Yeah.
You know, but lesson learned.
But then your dad, President Erap, Mayor Erap now, he issued
an apology. But that's how dad is.
He's a gentleman.
Yes. You know, I expected that. And as much as I wanted to issue a public apology, like I said, I don't want to create another monster.
Yes.
I humbly wanted to apologize to Ms. Chris Aquino myself, but you know, it was really a boo-boo on my side, you know, on my part. So.
Telling the truth, just kidding.
Yeah. You know, diba? Yes. Things like that, I should have just kept it to myself. Mm.
So now, are you still as outspoken, or do you keep more things to yourself?
I think I'm more cautious now because now I see how people react to what I say, and my opinions, my thoughts, and you know, I'm very opinionated.
Yes, and for the right reasons.
Sometimes, but then people take it out of context.
Mm. So it's not your words, but the context that people take it upon.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, I'm not one naman to talk ill about someone because I mean, you know, I've been through a lot. I mean, our family has been through a lot. So I don't want to inflict any emotional or mental, you know, pain on anyone because I know how that feels.
Or any other headache that to the people you love.
Exactly, no? Exactly.
How recently also people have also called your attention for protecting your brother, Jake.
Mm.
Oh, about posts naman with his former relationship with Andy, with stuff like that. How was that naman?
It was funny because people thought I knew everything about their relationship.
Yes.
He's my brother, yes, but I don't meddle in his personal, you know, issues with Andy or troubles. But you know, we talk about it, and I have nothing against Andy. She's a great girl.
Yeah.
You know, we're okay. We're good friends.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so whatever happens between them, I'm okay.
Uh-oh.
You know, I'm close to my brother. I'm okay with Andy. You know.
So good.
Mm-hmm.
Ayun. Alam mo, marami pa tayong pag-uusapan because, you know, there's so much about, you know, Jerrica, you know, is very elusive, you know, and she never really, like, talks about all of these things. Hindi niya alam, yung post lang niya, ang dami na nag-react kagad.
Yeah, I only did this because of you, okay?
Thank you. Ayun, alam mo, more about Jerrica Hercito, baby Isaiah, and what are her other plans in the future? Then, continue up for the Welcome back to the Tim Yap Show, and we have more surprises from Jerrica Hercito. Jerrica, okay. How is Bernard as a dad? Bernard Palanca is, of course, the father of your baby.
Yes, Bernard is an amazing father. He's very hands-on. He's the one talagang very, maalaga siya kay Isaiah. At night, he's one changing the diapers.
Oh.
He's very hands-on.
Oh, oh, oh.
You know, very, very. I have nothing to complain about. He helps me with the baby.
Teamwork talaga. Hindi ba nahirapan being a new mom?
Of course, it's hard. It was very difficult. In the first 2 months was very difficult. But now I'm slowly getting the hang of it.
Yeah, and now you're getting to enjoy that your baby is a beautiful baby boy.
Yes, I'm super.
And you know what? We have actually a surprise.
Yay.
He's here with us, baby Isaiah. Hello, Philippine television debut.
Yes, hi, babe.
What a cute little boy. Hello, baby Isaiah. How are you?
Ah.
Shake hands. shake hands.
Oh, I'm shaking.
Shake, rub elbows. Rubbing elbows with baby Isaiah.
Yes.
Wow. Why did you choose to name Isaiah?
You know, when I got pregnant, Bernard and I decided to take our spiritual life to the next level. So we are very active in church.
Wow.
And because of that, we decided to go biblical with his name.
And so was there anything from the verse of Isaiah that really...
No, it was more of like I prayed about it. Mm-hmm. And then I just kept seeing Isaiah everywhere
so
I went.
So it called, the name went to you?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, so his name is Isaiah Joseph.
Wow.
Joseph, of course, my dad.
Yes. How is former President Joseph Estrada reacting to baby Isaiah?
Amazing. He looks for him in the morning. He plays with him. You know, they have a good relationship.
Lolo loves you.
Daddy Lo.
Daddy Lo loves you.
Very much.
No? Diba?
Yeah.
Well, he has the face made for television, made for... Napaka-cute, di ba?
Thank you.
Ano, how do you guys bond? You know, what are mother, mommy Jerica and Isaiah bonding?
Putting him to
like?
Sleep? Mm-hmm. Usually, because now he's very magulo. He grabs everything.
Hindi ito mahilig matulog, no?
Hindi masyado.
Oo, kasi piling ko active na active.
Super active.
I can see in your eyes so much energy.
Yeah. Super.
Well,
you know, the usual. Nothing special. Like, I'm very... intuitive mother. I don't follow any, you know, books. Mm-hmm. I just go by yung back and forth. And I'm like how I feel and how he feels.
You're a very intuitive mother.
Yes. That's how we want. Me and Bernard, we are very intuitive parents. We don't really have books or anything like that.
Yeah. What are your future plans for your baby?
Well, you know, just like
everyone. Mag-aaral ba siya sa Pilipinas? Just like you, will you send him to school abroad? Mga ganon.
So far, nothing. I have not thought about that yet because I just want to enjoy him as a baby. But you know, if the time comes and the opportunity is there, why not?
But time flies too fast. And di ba, remember nung iska, kasilang mo pa lang sa kanya. And then now
he's turning one.
Di ba?
Of course, we talk about it. But like what I said, BJ and I are very, you know, we're all about the spiritual foundation of Isaiah. And wherever it brings us, when it comes to schooling, that's where we'll go.
So it's more for his spiritual development also.
Yeah, because we want to build a strong foundation for him.
Very good.
Mm.
Very good.
Yes.
I think, you know, like parents always forget that, diba? It's always where was the best for academic, say, spiritual growth, because
spiritual
that's the best foundation.
Yes, for me that's...
You agree, he agrees. So
he agrees.
I say, yeah, what have you to say to that? Yes?
And it really depends on what he gets into, like his passion. So I'm very sensitive to what he picks up or what, you know, what he likes.
What is he like?
Music.
What kind of music do you like, Isaiah?
Every kind. But when it's music, he stops and he listens and he observes, you know.
Musikero.
I like to be sensitive. If it's music, great. If it's politics, great.
Oh, wow.
The heavy heart.
If you had your choice, you wouldn't want your baby to get into politics.
Honestly, when you watch this, anak, I hope you understand that the answer is no. Yeah.
Ayun. Ay, sinap.
tap. Sleep na daw. Sleepy na.
Ayun, baby, I say, you know, this world is beautiful. You have great parents. So whatever field you choose to be in, I'm sure you will do great. Alam mo, wala kang insomnia. Diba? Good for you, baby Isaiah.
Yeah.
So keep on loving your mom the best way you can because she loves you too. So many people love you and you are lucky to be in this world. Right? That's true. You know that, right? Yes.
Wow, you guys are connecting, huh?
Right? Baby Isaiah. Keep it on. I feel you.
Mm.
Oh, you wanna sleep now?
Okay.
Okay, so you know, are you planning for maybe baby number two? May kasunod na ba si Isaiah?
Maybe in 2 years.
Oh.
Yeah, I want him to have a sibling.
Yes. Oh.
But I want to enjoy him first.
What is the best lesson that you've learned as a mother?
The world does not revolve around me after all.
from me to we.
From me to we. Yeah, it's very humbling talaga.
And what a beautiful Wii you have.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, congratulations, Jerica. And I'm really so happy for you and this bundle of joy that I know I will be hanging out with, talking to, and maybe on the same bed, we will be talking to him also when he gets to be more adult.
Of course.
I have something for you also. There you go. Oh, thank you so much.
I love your present.
There.
Yay.
That's for you too, you know. It's good for babies. So baby Isaiah, thank you so much. The Philippine television debut of Isaiah Ejercito. Ayon, palangka. Exactly. Yes. Thank you so much to Marriott Hotel Manila for being our home for our season 7. And Jerica and baby Isaiah, thank you so much. May more women and men be more inspired by you living your life from being, as you said, from being selfish to selfless.
Selfless, yes.
Diba? Yeah. It's all about we. Alam mo, we live in this world not just for ourselves, we live in this world to be of service for other people too. There.
That's right.
Diba? Tignan mo naman ang batang to, nakaka-good vibes. Good vibes gigil. Diba? Lagi sinasabi, dapat laging good vibes para laging good night. Diba? Sama si baby Isaiah and mommy Jerica Herzito. You are watching. Good night. Good night.